Mud Run obstacle course. And this is also my first Ignite. So when I was thinking about my theme and my title for this, I was also practicing for that and training for that. And I got to notice how many of the obstacles actually remind me of my day-to-day work at Common Core implementation. Our team captain, Diane Villanueva, on the bottom right, chose for us the team name To Be Spartan. Of course, referencing Hamlet's "To be or not to be, that is the question." That quote goes on to talk about the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune. So in this talk, I am going to try to compare the slings and arrows of Common Core implementation to the slings and arrows of the Spartan Sprint, which is the one that we did. This is a 4.8-mile obstacle course with 23 obstacles. I'm going to start with the javelin toss, which is kind of the most iconic of the obstacles because it most clearly references the whole Spartan thing. What I now know about throwing a javelin is that you are aiming at a single point, in this case a piece of straw very far away in a bale of hay, working to generate as much strength and power as you can, aiming straight at that piece of straw. Sometimes you miss. When we in this room work towards rigor, we are working from the Common Core definition of rigor. And sometimes, some of the stakeholders that we work with have a completely different bale of hay in mind. They are still talking about more difficult algorithms at a younger age. I'm a little bit scared of heights. So the 8-foot wall was one of the ones that I knew I was going to have to strategize and plan with my team, which is what I'm doing in this picture. Trick question, how high is an 8-foot wall? It's too high for me to get over by myself. It's not as if the Common Core invented teamwork or collaboration, but what is so cool about right now is that we are expected to create the environments for our students where they are smarter together. This is me training for the plate pull. You notice how clean the gym is. This is like that lesson plan where you've anticipated the math, or the community meeting where you know what questions you're going to be asked. No, no, no. The real world is so much muddier than whatever you design. So, like when you're in a large city where your mayor decides to weigh in on when students should take Algebra 1, for example, that is very muddy. But when it comes to it, what we train for is to get us ready for that. In all of the Spartan races, whenever you miss an obstacle like the rope climb, you have a 30 burpee penalty. And I know, right? It is like that in our work, though. We are always going back and re-engaging with whatever didn't work that well. So we are having harder conversations at greater depth. We are debriefing imperfect lessons, assuming learning. We are iterating on our core curriculum based on teacher feedback. In my case, I had 5 sets of burpees. Not fun. So here's a shout out to the elementary teachers who are carrying not only the Common Core in math, but also the Common Core State Standards in Language Arts, the Next Generation Science Standards, the new ELD framework, the Social Studies framework, layer on top of that standards-based report cards. I had a longer list. This did happen to me. I was sliding backwards down a hill, and my teammate Elisa stopped me with her own foot, but we had no way to go up, until somebody grabbed me by the hand and pulled me up. And I was able to turn around and offer Elisa a hand and pull her. And it is like that. Sometimes you are the one pulling, and sometimes you are the one being pulled. There are many hills. This one had barbed wire. That was my least favorite obstacle. But the one that scared me was the A-frame. And I think what matters is staying vulnerable in those places where we're learning the hardest things. And for me right now, that looks like being able to recognize and own my own white privilege in a system with racialized outcomes. Right? Thank you. The dunk wall was my favorite, which is going under a wall through muddy water. I look very glamorous in these photos. So joyful for me looks like doing math with a colleague and seeing something completely different because of the way that they see it, or them seeing something completely different because of the way that I see it. That's beautiful. And this is just about noticing the rare and wonderful beauty of mathematics. My BIM number was a prime number, 14,449. At the end, we jumped through fire, literally. You are braver because of the people that you get to work with.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
That is true. And I do think in San Francisco that we are doing something special and important and interrupting some long-held perceptions of what it means to be good in math. We are the members of SFUSD Math since the 2010 adoption of the Common Core. My hope for each of you is that you also get to find the people and become the people who are braver together. Yeah.